Noah, no, Noah, Noe, Noe. How do you pronounce the name of one of San Francisco's favorite and most family-friendly neighborhoods? And what is it about living in Noe Valley that makes people who live there obsessed about it? Let's find out.
Suitcase packed, trunks already gone. Going to San Francisco to make it my home, yeah.
San Francisco is a city of roughly 100 neighborhoods. Many of them are on hills or in valleys. And I would venture to say that the most popular valley in San Francisco is Noe Valley. Noe Valley is just, people love it. They're obsessed about it. And I really don't know why. So let's find out as I share some of my favorite things about this neighborhood and interview a friend who's lived in Noe Valley for well over a decade. So Noe Valley is a neighborhood, as I mentioned, that people are really super passionate about. I had a couple offices there for a while. I've sold some of my favorite homes there, and yet I still don't get it. So maybe this video will help us to figure it out, or not. So Noe Valley was named after Jose de Jesus Noe. He was the last Mexican mayor of Yerba Buena, which was the original name of San Francisco. Noe owned what is now called Noe Valley as part of his Rancho San Miguel Ranch. In 1854, he sold his land to a Mormon immigrant named John Mayers Horner. And despite the sale of his ranch to Horner, Noe's name stuck. Here are my top five reasons to live in Noe Valley. There's a lot of reasons, but these are the top five, and I think a lot of the people who live there would tend to agree with me on this, and I don't want to say anything about it, Noe Valley, because I don't want to get any of my friends or clients who live there upset with me. The number five reason to live in Noe Valley is that there are tech shuttles to the high-paying jobs in Silicon Valley. All the major Silicon Valley employers, such as Apple, Google, eBay, Facebook, and Yahoo, have shuttle buses that stop in Noe Valley to pick up their employees and transport them in comfort. These are double-decker, extremely comfortable buses, from what I've heard. I've never been in one, to their places of employment and amazing comfort. We semi-affectionately and slightly derisively refer to these young people as shuttle busers. But man, these kids are spoiled. They make good money and they get driven to and from work. What could be better than that? There are stops at the south end of Noe Valley on Dolores and 30th, as well as smack dab in the middle at Church and 24th. This was pre-COVID, of course, yet the access to get out of town to the peninsula is still a great draw of Noe Valley. The number four reason to live in Noe Valley is the great weather. Noe Valley is west of Twin Peaks, and Twin Peaks keeps a lot of the fog at bay, so it just stays over like on my side of the city. It's typically sunny most of the time, and it isn't as breezy as the other parts of the city. Some parts of the city gets really, really breezy. The number three reason to live in Noe Valley, as I alluded to already, is that it's incredibly family-friendly with good schools, such as both private and public, such as Alvarado Elementary, Claire Lilienthal. I have some clients whose daughter goes there. People who can afford to live here do so because of the well-known schools and other desirable neighborhood amenities, such as parks, churches, palm trees, lots and lots of things. In fact, in chatting with a local at my favorite restaurant there, where I go to about once a month, she shared that the nickname for Noe Valley is Stroller Valley. I didn't know that until today. So I learned something new. I like that. But Stroller Valley, just like Bernal Heights is sometimes called Maternal Heights, Noe Valley's nickname is Stroller Valley. She was there with her seven-week-old baby and a stroller. And she said how it was so great for families because everybody has babies and strollers and little ones. And it's just crazy sometimes just seeing all the families wandering around with kids and dogs. But she said the quality of life for families is really, really good. The number two reason to live in Noe Valley and why I go to Noe Valley are the coffee shops, the restaurants, the shops on 24th Street, 30th Street, Sanchez Street, Dolores Street, and other streets. I enjoy eating at Noe Teka on Dolores with my good friend Marty, who has lived in Noe Valley for well over a decade. He and I both highly recommend Noe Teka. It's a great place. Other well-known and beloved establishments include Novi, capital N-O-V-Y, La Chicha, Casa for Portuguese food, Lovejoy's Tea Room, which is right by one of my old offices, Chloe's Cafe, La Boulangerie, the Farmer's Market, Haystack, the Cheese Shop. Try saying that really fast. I guess I should slow down, right? Cheese Shops. And there's many, many more kinds of shops, just great shops, especially on 24th Street. And there's a really good olive oil called Olive This, Olive That. I forget, something like that. But I got some really good Meyer lemon olive oil there a while back. Still have a little bit left. Got some great oils and vinegars and love it. And the number one reason to live here in Noe Valley are the views of San Francisco Bay. There's many stunning homes, a lot of them newer or completely refurbished and remodeled, perched high on the hills of 27th Street, 28th Street, Diamond Street, and there's just really amazing views when you're that high up. So it's kind of funny, it's called Noe Valley, but part of it's on a hill, kind of adjacent to Diamond Heights up there, which is definitely on a hill. So my top five reasons to live here, to kind of sum up, are the tech shuttles, the wonderful sunny weather, it's family friendly, the fabulous restaurants, and the amazing views. Now, to be fair, no neighborhood is perfect. And Noe Valley, even the fabulous Noe Valley, has its drawbacks. If I were to share a few cons or reasons not to live in Noe Valley, they would be the high cost of housing and the lack of parking. It can take 8 or 10 minutes, sometimes longer, to find parking. As far as high cost of homes, as of the last 90 days, the median price for homes is just over $3 million, with the average price being $3.2 million. The least expensive home that sold was about $1.7 million, and the most expensive home that sold was about, I think, $6.5 million. So it's a very expensive neighborhood. I'd put it probably in the top 10 best or expensive neighborhoods in San Francisco. And of the 289 houses currently for sale in San Francisco, 14, just under 5%, are in Noe Valley, which is kind of interesting. That's one out of 100 neighborhoods, but has about 5% of the inventory. However, there were 30 sales in the last 90 days, or about 10 a month. So with an average of 10 sales a month, there's just a little under 1.5 months supply of inventory. What that means, despite being, as I mentioned, one of nearly 100 neighborhoods and having nearly 5% of the inventory, Noe Valley is still very much a seller's market. So despite being a very expensive city overall because of its desirability, natural beauty, fabulous restaurants, scintillating history, there are some awesome neighborhoods such as Noe Valley with compelling reasons to live in San Francisco. So for insider tips, my contact information is below. Please subscribe, be notified of my next video, and visit my website, RebeccaRealtor.com, and find your dream home in Noe Valley or somewhere else. There's also a link to homes currently for sale in Noe Valley and somewhere below the median price. So you can find your dream home in Noe Valley if you like schools and family-friendly neighborhoods and tech shuttles, or check out any of the other 100 neighborhoods we have here in the city. So I just want to say thanks for watching. Ciao for now. Again, please subscribe, share this video, and Noe Valley really is a truly fabulous neighborhood. If it just weren't for the expensiveness and the lack of parking, which is very typical of most neighborhoods in San Francisco, it would be perfect. So it's really, really close. So thanks. We'll chat soon. Ciao.
I left my heart in San Francisco.